here I am at the embassy opening with the one and only Danny Dyer. How are you?
I'm over the moon, babe, to be honest. It's very overwhelming, all this experience.
And how are you finding this gorgeous hotel?
It's just I've never experienced nothing like it. Honestly, I'm from the ghetto, East London. I ain't done bad myself. I mean, listen, I've got my own butler. I don't know what to do with him. It's very strange. He stands in the corner with his white gloves on.
And waiting to help you out.
Well, I don't know what he wants. You know, it's a new thing. I've never had a butler, so I mean, look, it is amazing. This place. It's paradise. This for me, if there is a paradise, surely this is it.
Of all the ladies in the world, who would you want to bring here, Sid?
My girlfriend, but she's at home.
Oh, you've left her at home.
Well, no, she's working, so.
Are there any wedding plans, Sid?
No.
Oh, that was a very quick no.
I'm going to tell you.
Now, I am such a lucky lady here on Wedding TV today because I am next to Tamer Hassan, the hottest actor in town.
I'd say I was a lucky one, wouldn't you?
So, are you enjoying yourself here at the beautiful Emirates Palace?
Do you know what? I flew in on Monday. I landed Tuesday morning. I've had an absolute ball. This place is amazing. Amazing.
And how romantic is this place?
So romantic. I want to throw you over my shoulder and give you a fireman's carry and take you to the jacuzzi. How's that? But don't tell the old man or the missus, you know what I mean? It's one of them ones. No, I'm only joking. No, it's absolutely romantic. As it happens, tell the truth, I can't wait to bring my wife and kids over here. They've sorted out a little suite for me on the house because my name's Hassan, the only Muslim Hollywood actor, right? Don't forget it. But yeah, it's romantic, it's great.
And so out of all the girls in all the world, who would you want to bring here?
Out of all the girls, I'd love to bring my little girl.
Aww.
My little baby girl, Alana. You know, we haven't been able to go on holiday for a long time because of her age. But now, you know, she's starting secondary school next year, so I think this is when the fun starts.
Oh, well, Simon, have a great time tonight. I hope to have a little dance later.
Oh, yeah, we will. We'll have a little boogie.
Actually, all these people I know. And when you strip them back, I've actually known these people and I've known them for a while. It's like I know you know what I mean, and your husband and everything. So it's kind of easy for me because I don't take any bullshit, right? They take me for who I am and vice versa. And I've been around the block a few times and I don't put up with any of that crap. They just come here because they like me and we get on. I sit them down, I give them a good time, which is what any club boss should do, any restaurant, you know, give them good food and everything. And I have no problem at all with them, right? The ones that I don't want to talk to, I don't talk to. So far tonight, obviously I have a new crowd in here that I don't know, but a few of them I do know, like this beautiful lady here.
She's gorgeous.
She's gorgeous.
There are many beautiful, gorgeous women here
tonight.
There
are a lot, aren't there? I'm feeling good.
I'm feeling good. Jason's not here.
No, there's some good-looking boys as well, aren't there? You know what I mean?
How do you cope with all the women, sort of female attention you must get being a film star?
It's half a myth, all that, you know what I mean? I get a lot of men, really. Not gay
men.
Men? Yeah, men. I think the films that I make, you know, what I represent are working-class men, so I get more men coming up to me, really, than women. It's just a mad thing. I think it's quite a rare thing. I'm proud of that fact. But you know what? I don't think about it too much. You know, I think we're living in a world now that everybody's quite obsessed with fame. And so, you know, you take it all with a pinch of salt, really. If you've got a bit of fame, then women go a bit mad around you, and it's a bit like, oh, whatever. It's nice for the ego, I must say.
I'm very happy. I'm going to walk in and make sure everyone's got a drink, please, God.
Yeah.
You know, but it's easy on the opening night when champagne is flowing. At the moment, we have had in the entire... We've been open 2 hours now. We've had two people left because it was a disagreement between... There was an ex-wife and an ex-husband.
Ooh, ex-wife and ex-husband. Ex-wife,
which is quite unusual in here at the moment.
It's a bit of argy-pargy.
Not anything... No drama. Just a bit of, I can't bear to see him with her. Okay, you know? And otherwise, the only trouble is they all have to get the loo. So there we go.
Well, Mark, you're doing a fantastic job.
Thank you.
I can't wait to get in there and party.
Hey, let your hair down.
I will. Bye, darling.
Bye, darling.
So that's just about it from me on the red carpet in Abu Dhabi. I want to go in and shake my booty. Come on.